It's time for Ryan's Roses, 102.7 Kiss FM. Are you ready, Sissany and Tanya?
Beyond ready. Baby.
Okay, listen in, everybody. So Jessica writes in an email that she was in San Diego with her son recently for his cross-country competition. Then when she got home, interesting, the wine glasses were right side up. She says, I store them upside down.
Oh.
Which is what I do, too.
You do?
I do.
Interesting.
But, so I don't understand. Is this a big deal? Does she think he had a...
Yeah, couldn't he? He just had someone over, like,
for
that,
wine.
For wine. What's the big deal with that? Michael, so Jessica, always puts stuff away, not the way I like it.
Yeah, I got it. Jessica, thank you so much for trusting us with this. Can you help us understand why the wine glasses is such a big deal?
Okay, so my husband does not drink wine. I was out of town, so one of us travels with my son to go to these cross-country competition.
That's a hard sport.
It's, oh my gosh. He just loves it, though. I mean, neither of us run. We don't know where he got it. He just decided. So, it's cute, but it's a lot of trouble.
Okay, so you come back and you see the glasses.
Yeah. And he doesn't drink at all, really. Like, maybe a beer once in a while, but just nothing. So this was very strange. And I asked him if he had anyone over that weekend. He was like, nope, just me.
Mm.
But there's just no reason he would have touched these wine glasses. So I'm thinking, like, why is he lying? You know what I mean? There's no reason.
Right, because now he's lying.
Make something up. Like, so I just think he had someone over. And the baby was sleeping upstairs. So now I'm just nauseous thinking about who is in the house.
But do you think he is cheating on you before this? Did you have any other... feelings before this?
Well, so we just had a baby. It's been really stressful. He's had some health issues. It's under control now, but like, we're just not connected.
You're not feeling the connection.
Yeah.
Okay. We're just,
it happens.
Like we just, we never watch TV like we used to. We never have anymore. Like, it's just, I kind of held out hope that this is just a rough patch and we'll get through it. But now he's lying about something, and he got squirrely about it, and that's why I'm so suspicious, I guess.
So he did get a little weird, and you said squirrely when you confronted him.
Yeah. There was no reason to kind of go, no, just, you know, there was no reason, so I don't know.
Is there anyone that helps out? Is there a nanny? Is there a cleaning person? Is there anyone that might have helped out?
I've racked my brain trying to justify the position of these glasses. We don't have a cleaning lady. We don't have a nanny. Like, we haven't even had anyone over in months. I did the dishes before I left.
Mm-hmm.
So I know I put them in there like I always do. You know, there's no, he didn't even, you know, he doesn't really clean.
And you didn't point out the glasses to him. These were just all questions to him. You didn't say like, well, why are these glasses upside down? You didn't say that?
No. I didn't say that yet.
On air
with Ryan Seacrest.
I mean, look, to me, she said a lot of things that are not great in their relationship. There's not a real connection. They're not intimate right now. She's been feeling disconnected. Then she sees these wine glasses at home, and he does not drink. So she thinks he had somebody over. And that was asked about. And he didn't say he had anyone over. So he lied about something, right?
Right. He's already lying.
So how much is he lying about? That is the question. Jessica, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Yeah.
I need you to say, Ryan, you have my permission to call, and then your husband's name on Kiss FM.
Okay. Ryan, you have my permission to call on Kiss FM.
Okay, be very quiet until we see who he sends the flowers to, and of course, what he writes on the card, okay?
Okay.
And
okay.
Good luck. Ryan's Roses. Here we go.
Hello?
Hi, is this Brandon?
Yeah, who's this?
Hi, Brandon. My name is Marcy. I'm calling from Beautiful Blooms. We deliver in Downey and most parts of L.A. How you doing this morning?
I'm pretty good. Yeah.
Great. So, you know, we're offering a promotion for local residents. And since you live in the area, it's a free dozen red roses that you can send to anybody that you'd like. We do this about once a month and trying to gain new customers. They're absolutely free. I don't need cash from you. I don't need your credit card or email address or anything like that. We can just start with the name of the person you want to send the flowers to, and we can write a note.
Yeah, I feel like there's nothing that's really free. So, what's the catch?
The catch is that we hope that you like the arrangements, and then you come back as a customer one day. But these are absolutely free. It's something that we do all the time here, and today you've been selected. So, is there someone that would want to receive some flowers, some roses today?
And you don't need my credit card.
I don't need your credit card. I don't need cash. I don't need anything like that.
Okay. All right. Then, yeah, sure. Sorry, what did you want then?
So who would you want to send? We can start with the note. What's their name?
Jessica.
Okay. And what would you like to put on the card?
I don't know. Some random woman called me today to offer me three roses. I hope that they brighten your day.
Well, maybe we leave the random woman part out, but...
Yeah, well, how romantic.
I'm hoping to get a... I
mean, you're not so romantic, Brandon. Oh, by the way, Brandon, your voice is being broadcast on the radio. I need you to know that. My name is Ryan. Ooh. We have your wife on the line with us right here. And...
Wait, what?
Yeah, we have your wife, Jessica, on the phone.
So... Okay... sorry, I'm just trying to catch up here.
Well, let me bring you up to speed. She is feeling a little disconnected in your relationship. And when she was away with your son at cross country, she came back and she saw two wine glasses stored the way that they're not normally stored. And you also, I think you don't drink much. So when you were asked about those wine glasses, what did you tell your wife?
Wait, so I'm on the radio right now and you're asking
me. Yeah, you need to know that.
Wine glasses? I'm sorry. This is too much.
So, Brandon, when what did happen with the wine glasses? Why were they flipped around not the way they're normally stored?
Oh, my God. I can't believe this is, that you're asking me this on the radio. I've already talked to my wife about this, and she's got a radio station calling me to offer some fake
Brandon,
flowers.
Who cares
about
that?
Yeah, so here we are.
What's the deal? What happened?
I can't.
Did you have someone over?
No, I mean...
Why are you stuttering? Why are you stalling?
I had a neighbor come over. I mean, I didn't have her come over. She just came over.
Okay,
Angie.
And then you didn't happen to open up wine bottles?
And you also didn't tell your wife that when she asked about it?
Right. She asked you if anybody came over. You said no.
Because I thought it would be a thing, and it was no big deal. Well, so I was just trying
to... It is a thing. It's definitely a thing.
Yeah, now we're here.
You're right by that. It is a thing.
Why would you lie? Why did you lie to me about it?
Babe, why would you bring me on a radio show to ask me about this when we've already talked about it?
We haven't talked about it.
What were you thinking? I was thinking I was trying to be a nice guy. You know, her husband left like 6 months ago. She shows up and
you guys,
she's
our next
crying.
Door neighbor. She's our next door neighbor, and she's.
And she's crying, and she's...
Yeah, okay, You drank wine. You drank wine?
Like a sip?
You don't drink.
I don't even
Yeah,
why
would you drink
like
with
wine.
Another woman and not your wife?
Seems strange.
And not tell her about it.
Exactly. So, immediately, Brandon, that night, when you guys spoke on the phone before you went to bed, which I'm assuming you probably did.
And Brandon, people
did
are busy.
Did something
happen? What happened?
That's a good question,
Jessica. Nothing happened. I poured some wine out, we talked, and I knew you were going to freak out. I didn't think you'd put me on the radio, but she just wanted to talk. And so we went out by the fire pit and we talked for a minute. That's it.
You went out by the fire pit with wine and you talked about what? That sounds pretty romantic.
Exactly, especially because you don't drink wine. So it's almost like you were trying to impress her.
I wasn't trying to impress her at all. I'm not attracted to her. It's very romantic.
I would go to a fire pit with two glasses of wine with my significant other. It's romantic.
Yeah, I would FaceTime Jessica during that time and be like, hey, why don't we all just chat about this together?
Well, I'm just confused why you wouldn't tell me. Like, were you trying to keep your options open? I just don't get the whole thing.
Oh, my God. Babe, I love you, but no, I'm not trying to keep my... This is insane. Nothing happened with her, and I knew you were going to react like this, which is why I didn't want to. I didn't want to mention it because I didn't want it to be a thing, because it wasn't a thing, because nothing happened.
No, it's a thing.
A little bit.
It's a thing.
We had a little bit of
wine.
I listened to her sob story.
Oh, it's a thing,
Brandon.
It's getting worse.
And also, you guys are distant in your relationship. I know for a fact you're not having.
Oh my God! I'm gonna hang up now, but babe, I can't believe you said that on the radio.
Well, she's spiraling, wow. Brandon. She's
how am I supposed to get an answer from you? You lied. You flat out lied, right? So what am I supposed to do now? I know, and now, like, if it was nothing, why wouldn't you have just said it?
And what else are you lying about here? Right? I mean, this could be just the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
Brandon, I'm going to ask you, did you cheat on your wife?
100,000% no.
Did you lie to your wife about that night?
I mean, I guess in that I didn't tell her about this happening, yeah.
Where's the bottle of wine? Did you guys finish it that night?
Was it red or white?
No, it was like...
Was it red or white?
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if it was red or white. It was a sip of red.
We don't even sit by the fire pit anymore. But that's what I'm saying.
Like you said, you took a sip of it. So does that mean that she drank the entire bottle because you just took a sip of it? Or did you guys pour the rest of it out? Because is the remaining of the bottle in the fridge?
I didn't bring the wine over. She was...
And then she left with her bottle?
I mean, she came to talk to Jessica.
He's lying. I don't know. This is over.
This is over.
Jessica, you really need to sit down.
I agree. I know you guys got to connect, but you got to find out what's going on. That is not okay. It is a thing. Brandon, thank you for talking to us.
Yeah.
Jessica, good luck, okay?
Yeah.
Sorry, Jess.
By the way, I'm upset with the thing. He covered up. It's a thing. Mm-hmm. A woman is over. It's romantic. It's a fire pit. It's wine. You don't drink. It's a thing.
Yeah, but also, let's not do any more irrelevant questions.
Okay, can you
What are irrelevant questions?
We're coming back to this.
We had more important things to ask him.
Honestly, I liked that question.
I am a winemaker studying to be one.
And I wanted to know how much they drink.
I wanted to know what it was. Also, thank you.